We'll be starting with DC generators now. As I already said, that DC generator is a DC machine which converts mechanical energy to electrical energy by means of electromagnetic induction. Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction says that whenever a conductor cuts a magnetic field or a coil cuts a magnetic field, there is a dynamically induced EMF is present, and is vice versa also is there. Whenever a conductor is having a current, a magnetic field is produced along the conductor. Now coming to the discussion of working of a DC generator. Rather than going into the discussion working directly, we start with two pole with a conductor. These are the two poles. This is the north pole and this is the south pole. But obvious, there will be a flux from north pole to south pole. A flux phi will be set up, and this flux is not an alternating one, this is a constant flux which will be there. Now, if I place my conductor here, so whether it will be having any induced EMF in it? Yes or no? No, it will not be having any induced EMF in it, because we have studied one formula, E is equals to d phi by dt. This is in relation to the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, that whenever a conductor cuts a magnetic field, whenever a conductor cuts a magnetic field, there is an induced EMF in it. So since my conductor is stationary and flux is also stationary, since the conductor is stationary and the flux is also stationary, so there is not any EMF induced in this conductor. So to have this conductor induced current, to have a generator, I should move this conductor. Let's move this conductor in this fashion, and but obviously this conductor, which is at position A, after some time it will be taking a position B, after some time it will be taking the position C, after some time it will be taking the position D, and this is position D. As I said, that there should be a change in magnetic flux to have the induced EMF. So when I start moving this conductor, when this conductor comes here, one can see again here, again here, and again here. One can see that the magnetic lines of forces are from north to south, and now the flux linkage is here, is this much only, here this much only, here this much only, and here this much only. Previously, when my conductor was on position A, the flux, total flux was linking and the flux was positive at that time. Since the flux is starting from north pole to south pole, at this point, point A, flux is totally, the conductor is actually totally linking with the conductor. It is totally inside the field. So it is totally linking with the conductor. So the maximum, according to this formula, since the flux is maximum at this point, so my EMF generated would be maximum. Since these two points B and D are out of the flux, so no, there is no linkage of the flux at this time. So according to this formula again, there will be no EMF generated on B and D. Now coming to point C, what happens that since the flux is starting from north pole and it is coming into south pole, flux is maximum at point C also, but in the negative direction, because if this conductor is now in the south pole zone, so the flux will be there and the flux will be maximum at that point also on the point C, but it will be in the negative direction. So if I have the graph of EMF generated, what will it will be? Rather than putting it here, I do it here. If I am having a graph of EMF generated with respect to time, what I will see at point A, the flux is maximum. So I will be having maximum EMF generated at that point. So this is the point A where my flux will be maximum. So my EMF generated would be maximum. Now transversing point is flux has reduced, so my EMF will be reduced, and at point B my flux is zero, so my induced EMF is also zero at this point. So at point B my induced EMF is also zero. Now coming to point C, my direction of rotation is like this. So after point B, then my conductor would be taking this position, then this position, then this position, then this position, and it will finally come to C position. From B to C, there is an increase in the flux, but obviously there will be increase in the EMF. But if you closely look at this, from B to D, B to C, flux is in the negative direction, because I am heading towards now south pole, which is in the, which is having a negative flux in comparison to my north pole. So since my flux is in now negative direction and it is going maximum, my EMF will also start building up from point B to point C, but in the negative direction, and it will attain a position maximum at point C. So in this way, point C will come approximately here. So I'll be having a maximum flux generated at, I'm having a maximum EMF generated at point C. Again, from point C to D, one can have a look that this, my conductor would be having this position, then this, then this, then point D will come. And at point D, since the, there is no flux, so no more EMF it would generate. So again, I will be able to see that, that from C to D, from maximum to minimum, there is a decrease in the flux, but that too in a negative direction. And at point D, there is no flux, so no EMF is generated. So my point D will come again at zero, and this would be point D. After that point D, D is a point where flux is not there, and again my conductor will take a position A. Again I will point A, my flux is maximum and it is in a positive direction again. So again closely looking at the points from D to A, my conductor will be taking position this, then this, then this, then point A. So at that point, from D to A, again my flux is building in a positive direction, So my EMF will also be building in the positive direction. So my point A will again come over here. So I have generated a EMF with respect to time, and if I increase this, this would be like this. So I can see I am getting a waveform of EMF. This is a DC generator. This is a form of DC generator, isn't it? Is that true? I am getting a DC generator over here. Yes or no? Exactly not. I am not getting a DC generator right now. I am getting an AC generator. If I see that my EMF generated over here is of alternating in nature. It is alternating in nature. So I got a generator, no doubt. My EMF is generated, but this is a AC generator. So for that, what I do, I have to have a commutator. So that this AC form will be converted into a DC form and my output will be a DC. So after putting a commutator, my generator would become a DC generator. Now, again coming to this, but in a different way.